Hi everyone, hope you're doing well from whatever you're watching this channel, depending on your time zone. Now, Ruto has been in the Nyanza region, meeting with the leaders, the residents, in the name of launching project, but we know it is a political tour, obvious. But then, my focus today is on the statement from the Siaya Senator, Oburu Odinga, a brother to Raila Amolo Odinga, elected on ODM ticket. Now, Oburu Odinga was now speaking to the youth, Gen Zs. Gen Z have been calling for Ruto must go. That was the protest. But we know how Ruto must go originated. First of all, reject finance bill. It was still in the cabinet. But the cabinet ignored the youth. It moved to the parliament. The youth said, reject finance bill. Members of parliament had an option to vote no. They voted yes. They ignored the youth. The youth now stormed the parliament. The next move now changed. Ruto must go. Because he has captured the parliament. He can bribe them. He can intimidate them. Those in UDA ticket, especially from Mount Kenya and Rift Valley. So it changed to Ruto must go because he has become worse. He cannot listen to the youth. And that is the kind of protest we have had. They even threatened to go to State House after storming Parliament. With that, we know how ODM came into this existence. But what was really good is that youth pushed William Ruto to dissolve his cabinet. So Oburu Odinga is reacting to the youth. And his question is that if you say Ruto must go, what next? How will he go where? And I will either what next? That is the question. What next? Today is referring to William Ruto is our son from the valley here. It is no longer about Ruto must go. He is telling the youth that Ruto should not go. Because the question is what next? This statement from Oburu Odinga might not be aiming at Kenyans, but Oburu Odinga might be communicating to a different person. Haongeleshi wa Kenya, anaongelesha a different person. So first of all, listen to him, then I'll take it to another statement to justify what he is saying in this statement for you to understand where he's heading to.
Tusiendelee na hii mambo ya euphoria ya kusema Ruto must go, Ruto must go, Ruto must go, Ruto akienda, basi sisi ni nini badai? Akienda ni nini badai? Siniliwambia njini muangalie hiyo kabisa? Niliwambia njini muangalie hiyo kabisa? Basi, sasa tuko hapa. Tuko hapa na Rais Ruto, amekuja kututembelea. Na yeye ni mtoto wetu kutoka hapa milima. Yeye pia.
Now, some time back, Oburu Odinga called for a press conference. And in that press conference, he referred to William Ruto and Rigathi Gachagua as devils. But after referring to them as devils, he quickly went on to say that if we are saying Ruto must go, we should understand that Gachagua will take over from William Ruto. Ruto and Gachagua are devils. But Gachagua is the worst devil. So, in Oburu Odinga's view, Ruto must stay because Gachagua is the worst devil.
The constitution says the president can resign if he finds that things are too hot for him. But if he resigns, the result is that his deputy takes over. And I don't know whether Gachagua is better than Ruto. To me, they are all the same. They are devils. Because, you know, I don't see the, both of them, and Gachagua is even worse in my view. Because he talks about shareholding. We understand our country into a shareholding company, where only those who voted for Kenya Kwanza have shares. The rest of Kenyans would not vote for Kenya Kwanza, and we are more than half.
Now, as we continue with the panel discussion, just a quick request for those who are watching and you not yet subscribe, please consider subscribing. To our returning subscribers, I must say thank you so much. And again, to all our viewers, please give this video a thumbs up. Thank you so much. And back to this discussion. Inasmuch Oburu Odinga is speaking to the youth, the person targeted in his statement is Gachagua. Remember, when Gachagua was not in good terms with William Ruto, there was protest. Ruto would call for a press conference in State House, Nairobi. Gachagua would rush to Mombasa State Deputy Residence and issue a statement also. If there is an agreement, they will be standing on the same floor, issuing the same statement. Gachagua asimame hapo, Ruto asome. But because they were in disagreement, it shows that definitely there was internal fight. Gachagua will go to an extent of exposing government by sharing critical classified information to the public. He was accused of funding the youth. But to me, I don't trust that. Though we know very well that most of youth who are protesting, especially in Mount Kenya, Nyeri, the headquarters of the protest, it was at governor's office. They used to go there for endorsement of governor, and Governor Mutahi Kahiga would endorse the youth, support them. And yes, that's where they stood. That's what they were pushing for. So there was a kind of Gachagua fighting William Ruto at his back. So in that way, if Gen Z's were going to succeed, then Gachagua becomes a beneficiary. So Oburu Odinga is communicating to Gachagua that you are the worst. Because if we say Ruto must go, it means his deputy should take over. And if his deputy takes over, according to Oburu Odinga, he's the worst. Because Ruto must go. He has gone. What next? Gachagua is next. But he goes on, relying on Gachagua's primitive politics of regional and tribalism. The issue of shareholders. He's basing his allegation on that. To some extent, it's justified because that is what Gachagua said. That we have shareholders. They're running a company, forgetting that Kenya is a country and Kenyans are citizens who pay taxes for the government to run, for Gachagua to get salary, for Gachagua to be facilitated in his transport, for Gachagua's food, including the water he's drinking, it is our taxes. And so we are your taxes, ni kampuni. So Oburu Odinga is speaking to Gachagua, and the issue is that Ruto is not going anywhere. We are going to defend him. Now he's calling Ruto our son. So we took on nylons hapa. Biashara imekuwa ya nylons. We have River Lake nylons and Highland nylons. Umeungana. No, no, that's why he's saying our son. So to that point, in as much as Gachagua was present, and if you check in the newspaper, you would see the revival of supremacy fight between Ruto and Gachagua is emerging. I said to you here yesterday that the warm welcome of William Ruto in a Nyanza region, in the supermassive crowd we saw, it is a threat to Gachagua. When there is rejection of William Ruto in Nyanza, that one is a plus for Gachagua, because Ruto will have no any option but to go for Gachagua when they want to defend his position. But a warm welcome like this one, it tells Gachagua that you are replaceable. So Gachagua cannot sit pretty. That is the message here. Two devils, but one is the worst. So they are rejecting Gachagua and they are silently fighting regarding Gachagua in his presence. They are fighting Gachagua. So Gachagua is an unwelcomed guest in Ruto's Luo Nyanza tour. They don't want Gachagua. So they have to use every word to justify William Ruto's, to remain in office. But they are planting a seed among the youth that our enemy is not Ruto, it is Gachagua. But we know our enemies are Ruto, Gachagua, and his government. Those are the enemies to our economy. That is our understanding. But Oburu Odinga is trying to wash William Ruto clean. But to paint Gachagua as the most dirty. Yet we know both of these individuals are dirty. So he was playing politics here. But this should not stop youth from asking a government to be responsible. Tribalism politics has no any help to our lives. Just go to Mount Kenya. We will use it as a study case. Most of the people who appointed this government came from Mount Kenya. Cabinet ilikuwa na watu kama nane from Mount Kenya. But the 8 cabinet secretaries did not solve the problems of people of Mount Kenya. They were still on the street. So regional tribal politics has no room. It can't help us in any way. Appointment of people into government cannot solve our problem. But yes, it is good to have the face of Kenya rather than portraying the tribal card all over. Because for me, when I look at William Ruto, I see a tribalist president. If I look at Gachagua, and you ask even any child, they will tell you Gachagua is a tribalist. Gachagua kama ni president, alikuwa deputy mzuri. Lazima Gachagua angekuwa na watu wake moja, anaweza kuja Ukambani, aseme Ruto, this person, mpenzi, yes, mtu wake. Akuwe na rafiki wake, hata huku Western, Ruto, pea mtu fulani, kazi. Rafiki yake karibu. Hata akibakisha 4 kule Mount Kenya, ama 5. Hizi zingine angekuwa. So, we would see Gachagua as the face of Kenya, because hako na watu wamepanda hapa, akapanda pale. I mean, you are just one step to the presidency. So Buru is communicating, Gachagua is unwanted guest in Nyanza, and it is a warning to him. Ajipange. Kwa sababu Gachagua angekuwa mzuri wangesema, Ruto aende, Gachagua baki. Wangeendelea kusema hivyo. Lakini hawana urafiki wowote na mheshimiwa Rigathi Gachagua.